And if you want to stay awake at night, that's one way to do it, is like to lay there in a completely silent forest and hear footsteps in the middle of the night. I'm about 90 minutes into the hike this morning. Stopped and got a little bit of water, not a full supply, because I only have a few hours to go before I get to the trailhead for Front Royal. But last night at the stealth site on the side of the trail, I was laying there and I wake up in the middle of the night, but you know, several times a night, but it was completely silent. No birds, no tree frogs, no perceived bat noises, because I don't think they're bats anyway. No owls. But when it's completely silent like that, and it's very rare, I don't even remember another night that it was silent like that. An occasional tree rustling from the wind, but when it's silent like that, you hear the footsteps on the forest floor. And there was one time last night, it woke me up and I was listening to whatever it was walking through nearby. And you know, it could have been a deer. I doubt it was a bear. But I also learned yesterday, I ran into some day hikers. It was about where I got water yesterday. Shortly after that, ran into some day hikers and they said, "Hey, did you see that bobcat back there?" I said, "No." And they said, "Well, we got video and a picture of it," and they showed it to me. I was like, "Yeah, there's actually bobcats up here." And they said, you know, it took a look at them and then, you know, it took off running. So apparently they're afraid of humans too, not the attack kind. So anyway, that the footsteps last night, I tell you, when you hear that, and I there's probably footsteps all the time, you know, when I pick a stealth site, it's just that they're masked by all the other sounds of the forest. But last night they weren't. And if you want to stay awake at night, that's one way to do it, is like to lay there in a completely silent forest and hear footsteps in the middle of the night. So anyway, that was a new experience for me, but heck, it could have been a human, who knows. going to the bathroom at another stealth site. So I think I'm on my... No, there's a couple of climbs left. Small ones, but most of the rest of this morning is... I hear noises. Most of the rest of this morning is downhill, kind of, into the pickup point. It's a nice autumn morning, and I'm enjoying the hike. Haven't seen another hiker yet. I did see a hammocker back there, still sleeping. But, you know, when you get up before dawn, you pretty much got the trail to yourself. And, you know, you kind of get to catch whatever sunrise you can. I haven't had a view, but I've seen, you know, the sunrise through the trees. And that's always remarkable, especially the first colors over the horizon. Never forget that. I mean, because you just don't get that. You know, back in, you know, city or suburbs or, well, I mean, you can, but not when you're up in the mountains. You're just on a, you just have a different perspective. Not just of sunrises. You have a different perspective of everything. And that's what I'll come out of here with. I'm starting to think, I'm kind of not going to know how to operate back in real life right away. You know, I'm filtering water here. I won't be doing that anymore. I have to inflate my mattress every night, which I won't be doing that anymore. But I will have somewhat of a real cup of coffee. That's the trade-off. You know, there's pros and cons to everything. So, it's funny. I'll probably get a real cup of coffee. And I'll go, man, I miss that fake coffee. But, so I'm going to get down the trail because my arm's tired from holding the camera. I don't have any muscles anymore. So, onward! Onward. All right, it's the morning of the fifth day in the Shenandoahs, and I am at the northern entry into the Shenandoah. So I'm guessing I've officially finished hiking the Shenandoahs in Virginia. There's the permit box down there. So it was a wonderful experience. And I'm going to say it was, for me, it was mostly rocky. There are some, like the last couple of miles, smooth trail, no doubt about that. But it was rockier than I expected. So based on what everybody was saying about it. So yes, they're rolling hills, you know, no sharp peaks or anything, but still a lot of rocks and sharp, jagged trails to walk on. So it was fun. So we're on to Front Royal. I just arranged a shuttle to pick me up. So that's a good feeling knowing that I got a ride. The first shuttle driver I called, he said he was sick in bed. So I was like, okay, but there's numerous resources to pull from, fortunately. So I got a ride that's going to meet me pretty sure on time at a reasonable cost. And I am going to soak my body in Epsom salt. So if this is not financial advice, but if you know of a company that produces the Epsom salts, go ahead and invest in their stock because I'm buying a dump truck load of it to soak in. So I got a couple more hours before I get to the trailhead, and it looks like it's mostly downhill, but even when it's mostly downhill, yeah, I say mostly downhill, I'm going uphill right now. So onward. I'm less than a mile away from my pickup point for Front Royal stay. And it sounds like it's gonna get kind of noisy down here by the road crossing. So this will be an extended stay because of potential weather. If the weather pattern, which is precipitation, if it dissipates, then I'll leave earlier than I anticipate, but this might turn into like 4 zeros or something. But I'm determined to hike my final 3 days if I survive before I get there, my final 3 days with good weather. And so it looks like a bunch of rain for an extended time and then sunny weather after that. So that's my weather window. I was fortunate enough, I'm very grateful for, my entire hike through the Shenandoahs were dry. It didn't mean the water sources were dry though. So there were some, most of the water sources were flowing. Even though sometimes it was a trickle, I could still manage to fill some water bottles. So, but I'm just running out of gas. It's kind of like, if you ever watch a horse race or Kentucky Derby or something like that, and they round the final turn into the home stretch, and the jockey's, he's starting to kind of whip his horse a little bit to help him out and get him to the finish line. And no, this isn't a race, but that's what I feel like. It's the final turn into the home stretch and I'm a little exhausted. So I'm looking forward to seeing my girls again and some recovery time. After today, I'll have about 53 miles to go. So I figure 3 days, 4 days max to finish it up, including a section called the roller coaster. No tall mountains, no 4,000 peaks left. Just a Front Royal to Harper's Ferry hike. So I'm gonna get into Front Royal, do my last resupply, which won't be very big. My last laundry load for the hike. My last, I guess, town stop, if you wanna call it that. I don't think Front Royal is known as a trail town, so much. I guess it is. There's some hostels there, I think. But my last shower before the end of the trail. That's also, I mean, I'll be taking daily showers after this, but it's kind of a hiker shower. So, kind of the final everything coming up. So, I will see you on the other side of Front Royal, Future Hickory. You almost got this muffin and button. See you soon. I still got all the buttons and my tiger's eye. And is my ancestors. All right, so onward to Front Royal.